becoming a big issue for everybody, even a winner like Jimmie Johnson.
Stage points, playoff points.
Triple turn one, Jimmie Johnson slams the outside retaining wall. May have had a brake or a tire failure going into turn one. He cut down across the grass. Now another car, Jamie McMurray, is up into the wall. I'm going to say that was a brake failure on the Jimmie Johnson car. He came into turn one at the braking point. Right front tire exploded. He went down through the grass, head on into the wall. Debris all over the racetrack. May have cut a tire down on the Jamie McMurray machine. Right now the concern is for Jimmie Johnson. The window net is down. He is climbing out, or beginning to climb out of the race car at the exit of turn one after an absolutely vicious shot into the safer barrier.
And Jamie McMurray's car is beginning to burst into flame. There's flame coming to the right side, and Jamie has pulled the car, nosed it into the safer barrier gently, and he has bailed out of that car as it slowly becomes engulfed in flames.
Well, our first caution flag of the afternoon at lap number 96. Jimmy was just talking about trying to get those stage points, so don't worry about that. That's all over. And Slugger Labby, one of your progressive keys to the race was save the brakes, and that was a brake failure.
It certainly looked that way, and that hurt. You know, that wall is not what you want to be in, for sure. And I'm not exactly sure what happened to the one car, Jay McMurray, but he had a violent hit as well. And, you know, brakes, you got to take care of them. And like I said, the entry speed is tremendous, 208 miles an hour, and something's got to give, and these brakes can only do so much. And, you know, you think you hurt the brakes on entry, but it's really not. It's down these straightaways when the brakes cool off, and then they have to heat back up on entry. So it's actually you hurt your brakes going down a straightaway, not on entry of the corner. So it definitely a hard hit, and I'm glad to see Jimmy get out of the car.
All right, we got a lot going on. We got Jimmie Johnson, who is kneeled down next to his car. McMurray's car continues to burn. Let's first cover Jimmie Johnson, Dave.
Jimmy has gotten out of the car. He's a little bit worse for wear, Jeff. Took a vicious lick here in turn one. Got out of the car, kind of hunched over. Now is down on his knees. No doubt about it, it's at least taken the breath from Jimmie Johnson. But he is out of the car. He is speaking to the EMTs and rescue workers. He did get out of the car under his own power.
Coming off a victory last week at Dover, riding high coming into Pocono here this weekend. And you heard us just... checking in on Jimmie Johnson. What they were talking about was trying to gain stage points. That's how fast it can happen. He's in the wall, out of the race. And Mike Bagley, same situation for Jamie McMurray.
Yeah, good news is Jamie McMurray has climbed from his car. Matter of fact, he bailed out, and he climbed over the safer barrier and was standing over in the grass. Safety crews have arrived on the scene and have applied a lot of fire retardant material. And with that, it created this huge smoke bank of that material that cars had to drive through. And with the wind, that material is strewn all over the racetrack. Jamie is in the ambulance. The fire is out, and the crews are working on getting McMurray's car hooked up to the wrecker.
Here's a communications, the in-car radio communications between Jimmy and Chad.
All right, man, you sure you are, I am?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Whew, I got away with one there.
The one car crashed behind us as well. I don't know if maybe there's something on the track.
No, when I hit the brakes, my pedal went to the floor.
There you go. Brake problem taking Jimmie Johnson out here at Pocono this afternoon. Caution here at Pocono Raceway. It's turned into the red flag because of all the cleanup that will have to be done, not only in turn one from Jimmie Johnson's crash, but down the Long Pond stretch entering turn number two for the other crash involving the car of Jamie McMurray. Let's check in first with Dave Moody.
Jimmie Johnson has gotten out of the car. He has been attended to. The ambulance is on the scene, and he'll take the mandatory ride back to the infield care center. Cleanup effort is underway here in turn number one. My best guess, having seen a couple of these here at Pocono, that wreck very reminiscent of the one that claimed Jeff Gordon's car a few years ago, as he exploded a brake rotor coming into turn number one and hammered the outside wall. Gordon's car hit driver's side first. Johnson fortunate enough to keep it passenger side first, right side first. Jamie McMurray ran through the debris. I'm looking and don't see any fluid on the racetrack, so I'm guessing it was probably a chunk of the brake rotor off of the Jimmie Johnson car that caused the problem for Jamie McMurray. McMurray made it all the way to turn two before bailing out of his blazing race car. Jimmie Johnson, again, out of his machine. He'll take the ambulance ride back to the infield care center.
And an update from turn two and Mike Bagley.
Yeah, right now, safety crews have just about gotten things buttoned up over here, Joe. One last piece of business is to get that flame retardant material off of the racing surface. But right now, the one car has been hooked up to the wrecker. Matter of fact, they're going to make the left-hand turn, go back to the infield, but that car is just torn all to pieces after catching fire after making contact with the wall in front of Dave.
Jimmie was running in seventh. Jamie McMurray was running in the ninth spot. Under the red flag, Kyle Larson is the leader. From Pocono Raceway, this is the Motor Racing Network, the voice of NASCAR. The cleanup work continues, and is there any wall repair going on there, Dave Moody, in front of you in turn one?
No, the safer barrier appears to be undamaged, Joe, but the problem is it's not so much debris as a debris field all the way through turn one. There is some fluid down. That fluid appears to have come from the Jamie McMurray car. It rides all the way up next to the outside safer barrier through turn one and then down to the inside on the back straightaway, mirroring the path that McMurray took. My guess would be that the debris, the ruptured brake rotor from the Jimmie Johnson car, probably took an oil line or the radiator out of the Jamie McMurray car, and after that, Jamie was pretty much along for the ride. The Jimmie Johnson car has been taken away on the flatbed. They've put down a ton of oil dry here through turn one and two. They're running the sweeper trucks over that. I imagine they're going to have to give the entire track a pretty good once over here to make sure that there are no remaining pieces of that brake rotor or any other debris off the Jimmie Johnson car.
All right, Dave, thank you very much. A lot to revisit here regarding Jimmie Johnson and Jamie McMurray. We'll do that here in just a couple of moments as we sit under the red flag here at Pocono with Kyle Larson leading over Kevin Harvick in the Ford. Kevin trying to go to victory lane for the first time this season.
Let's go to the care center now and Kim Kuhn.
Yeah, Jimmie Johnson has been released. Jimmie, a hard hit. First off, are you okay? We saw you take a moment there on track before getting to the ambulance. And then second, you said brake issue over the radio. What was the problem?
Yeah, I'm good. It definitely gets your attention when you lose the brakes. I haven't had a scare like that since my Watkins Glen crash in 2000. So it's a situation a driver never wants to be in. I can only assume I got the brakes too hot. And when I went to the brakes that time into turn one, they failed. I saw a little bit of smoke as I hit the brake pedal, and the pedal just went to the floor. So at that point, I stuffed it in third gear, and I was just trying to slow it down somehow, some way. And got some speed out of it, and fortunately hit at a decent angle in the wall, and just scared me more than anything. So I'll go change my underwear and head home.
That's Jimmie Johnson. Glad you're okay, Jimmie.
We do want to hear from Jamie McMurray, and he has just come from the care center.
Yeah, Jamie, we saw your Cessna Chevy go up in flames. What happened?
So I lost brakes as well, and as I went down the corner, I felt like I didn't have any brakes, and I was able to pump them a little bit and get some pedal, so I thought I was going to be okay, and then I don't know if I got into a little bit of oil from Jimmie or what happened, but just lost control and just kind of along for the ride. Really fast racetrack to lose brakes on.
There's Jimmie McMurray. Two drivers out today due to brake issues.